look, I'm just doing a multitude of things, as all good CEOs should be doing. And we're building a big rocket right now. So I'm down in Mississippi doing engine tests with the team here. So there's a lot on.
Okay, well, let's just cut right to the chase then. Give us an update on the development of some of these rockets that you're working on, specifically of Neutron. Tell us what's going on. What's the latest?
Yeah, so Neutron is a kind of a solution to kind of the mid-launch monopoly, as you could say. So it's scheduled to launch mid next year, and we're working hard right now on lots of things, propulsion, building complete launch sites and factories and all of the components that go into a big rocket.
So can you give us an update in terms of, when you anticipate that this is going to be, ready for deployment, a little bit in terms of the time frame? Yeah.
Yeah, sure. So we're looking to get this vehicle on the pad the next year and get it away. So hopefully people won't have to wait long. But what I would say is it's a very different looking rocket. Like if you see it, it's very much an advanced launch vehicle for the modern times, and lots of innovation in it that should really drive down launch costs even further.
It is pretty phenomenal. Folks who listen, watch us, know that my dad was involved in doing kind of work. He was an engineer, aeronautical, and worked on a lot of guidance systems for the original space program. So we kind of grew up with it. And he's not around, but I always think he would find it kind of amazing, these rockets that can come back and be reusable, because it's just not the way it was. Talk to us again how you kind of rethink about how you are doing it so differently than it was done, by government programs for so long.
Yeah, I mean, we'll start with their small rocket, the little Electron rocket, that you aptly pointed out has got its 51st mission tomorrow. And, we re-enter that through the Earth's atmosphere completely passively and then push it out of the ocean. Neutron is a propulsive landing, so we land it on a barge or back at the launch site. But if you look at the vehicle, when it lands, there's no bit missing. There's no bearing mission missing. There's no second stage missing. It's literally as it looks, as it took off, and ready to load the next customer's payload in and go again.
Peter, I said that you're taking on SpaceX. You're taking on Elon. If we look at the numbers, as of mid-July, SpaceX had launched 70 rockets this year. Rocket Lab had launched just 8. Again, this was mid-July. How do you compete with SpaceX? Is there enough room for both of you, given that they were quite a bit earlier to the game and they're bigger at this point, so much bigger?
Yeah. And look, sometimes it's a huge advantage to be a first mover, and sometimes it's an advantage to be a second. And, I would point out that if you look at the Electron rocket and how quickly that ramped, it was actually the fastest rocket to reach 50 launches in commercial history. Faster than SpaceX and faster than anybody else. It will continue to do that. First to be, we expect it to be first to get to 100 as well. Sometimes you can start at the back, but it doesn't mean you finish last, that's for sure.
Yeah.